That Sunday on my oath, the rain was a heavy overcoat on a poor poet. And when the rain began in fleeces of water to buck leap like a goat, I was only a walking penance reaching Kiltart. And there, so suddenly, that my cold spine broke out on the arch of my back in a rainbow, this woman surged out of the day with so much sunlight that I was nailed there like a scarecrow. But I found my tongue and the breath to balance it, and I said, if I bow to you with this hump of rain, I'll fall on my collarbone, but look, I'll chance it. And after falling, bow again. She laughed. Ah, she was gracious. And softly she said to me, for all your lovely talking, I go marketing with an ass. I'm no hill queen, alas, nor Ireland that grass widow. Sorry on, sweet Raftery, or you'll keep me late for mass. When we left the dark evening at last, outside her door she lighted a lamp. Though a gaming company could have sighted each trump by the light of her unshawled pole, and indeed she welcomed me with a big quart bottle, and I mooned there over glasses until she took that bird, the phoenix, from the spit. And Raftery, she said, a feast is no bad dowry. Sit down now and taste it. Well, if I praised Ballylee before, 'twas only for the mountains, where I broke horses and ran wild, and not for its seven crooked, smoky houses, where seven crones are tied all day to the listening top of a half door, and nothing to be heard or seen but the drowsy dropping of water and a gander on the green. But, boys, I was blind as a kitten till last Sunday. This town is earth's very navel. Seven palaces are thatched there of a Monday, and oh, the seven queens whose pale, proud faces with their seven glimmering sisters, the Pleiades, light the evening where they stroll, and one can find the well by their wet footprints and make one's soul. For Mary Hynes, rising, gathers up there her ripening body from all the love stories, and rinsing herself at morning, shakes her hair and stirs the old gay books in library. And I'll wager, now that my song is ended, Loughrea, that old dead city where the weavers have pined at the mouldering loom since Helen broke the thread, will be piled again with silver fleeces. Oh, the new coats and the big horses, the raving and the ribbons and Ballylee and hubbub and uproar. And may Raftery be dead if he's not there to ruffle it on his own mare, Shank's mare, that never needs a spur. But ah, sweet light, for your face coins my heart's very metals, isn't it folly without pardon that Raftery goes singing so that men east and west come spying on your vegetable garden? We could be so quiet in your chimney corner, but how could a poet hold you any more than the sun burning in the big bright hazy heart of harvest could be tied in a hymn? Bless your poet then, and let him go. He'll never stack a haggard with his breath. His thatch of words will not keep rain or snow out of the house, nor keep back death. But Raftery, rising, curses as he sees you stir the fire and wash down, that he was bred a poet, whose selfish trade it is to keep no beauty to himself.